6:43 on Daybreak. Welcome back, everybody. And new this morning, a few weeks back, we told you about a cooking competition between some local pop-up restaurants with retail space on the line.
Yeah, and now they're ready to announce the winner, and they're doing it right here on Daybreak. What an honor. We've got Lauren Hall is downtown this morning with announcing the winner. Good morning, Lauren.
Hey, good morning, guys. Yeah, I'm standing right outside the space right now on Main Street. It's that little building sandwiched in between the big two, 808.5. One of the neighbors is the Oxford Pennant Manufacturing Space. On the side of their building is that big Keep Buffalo a Secret mural. On the other side, it's the Kimmelberg Law Office and co-working space. But that little space, about a year from now, will be the future home of Bloom and Rose Jewish Deli. They just won the contest for free rent for a year. And here's their story.
Kanish is basically just a nice flaky pastry on the outside, stuff full filling on the inside. We have roughly 20 flavors that we do.
It was a few years ago that the team behind Bloom and Rose started carving out a niche for Kanish in Buffalo.
The Kanish itself has kind of been our little beacon of, would Buffalo accept the idea of a really high quality Jewish deli?
They bake the little balls of dough here at their commissary kitchen in Chandlerville and sell them at local farmers markets, grocery stores, and online.
Ideally, we're going to just stick with Kanish and go more retail and try and see if we could just produce them in mass.
That was before they entered the Make It On Main contest to win a year of free rent at this little building sandwiched between two others on Main Street in downtown Buffalo.
You know, so it's sort of dilapidated, hasn't seen a tenant in many years.
Eamon Riley is the director of development for Character, a property company. They own the space and launched the contest to help a local business get back on its feet coming out of the pandemic.
And we thought, you know what, let's give back. Let's have this contest so we can fill this with a really cool tenant.
I think we submitted at 4:59 when the deadline was 5 o'clock on a Friday. We didn't think anything was going to really come of it.
But the crew performed so well at the interview and the final food truck battle held outside the space last month that they won.
It was just like a static feeling for a while.
Now they'll finally get to open that Jewish deli they've been dreaming of. For Zach Rosenblum and his wife Lois, the sole Jewish partners of the business and the inspiration behind its name, it's a labor of love.
It gives us an opportunity to take something traditional like Jewish cuisine that has such a long past and do something new and funky.
So next steps here, they're actually going to tear down the existing building at 808.5 Main, and then they're going to rebuild it to the specifications that Bloom and Rose would like to see for their deli. It should be open in about a year, and in that time, they'll also be getting some business consulting and training from the folks over at Oxford Pennant and from Lloyd, which you saw they borrowed their taco trucks for that food truck event. We have much more information about Bloom and Rose, this contest, and the future of this building here on Main Street on our website, WGRZ.com. For now, I'm Lauren Hall reporting in downtown Buffalo. Pete and Melissa, back to you.